Tony Hsieh, the alpaca-loving visionary, created a legendary customer service culture at Zappos that grew their revenue from $1 million to $1 billion. In today's episode, we will tell you how Tony Hsieh got rich.
My name is Dan Henry, and when I was 16 years old, I decided that I wanted to be rich. So I studied as many wealthy entrepreneurs as I could and used what I learned to create my own successful business. The purpose of this channel is to share my research with the world and show you how they got rich.
New York Times bestselling author, former Zappos CEO, and childhood entrepreneur Tony Hsieh has left an undeniable mark in the workplace. His ability to invest in ideas, businesses, employee satisfaction, and customer satisfaction turned him into one of the wealthiest alpaca-loving men in America, with a net worth of $840 million. December 12, 1973, Richard and Judy Hsieh welcomed their firstborn son, Tony Hsieh, into the world. As a boy, Tony knew he needed cash in his pocket to have the freedom to do whatever he wanted. So that little guy got busy. He tried investing $33.45 in a box of worms to build a worm farm, created his own newspaper, put together garage sales, and even tried peddling Christmas cards in the heat of summer. Christmas in August was a bit of a hard sell. Though none of these ventures proved successful, it didn't keep Tony from continuing to try again and again. After all, Tony was no quitter. He came up with a plan for selling photo buttons. His parents invested $100 to get his business started. The young man didn't just sell buttons, he made them and sold them via mail. Tony had picked a winner. People loved wearing tiny portraits of their favorite celebrities, their children, and even themselves. He was only in middle school, but he was earning $100 each week, enough to not only pay his parents back, but also to employ his younger brothers in order to fulfill all the orders. In high school, Hsieh worked as a video game tester and programmer. Through his work, he learned life lessons that he would carry with him into adulthood. He learned that thinking outside the box was crucial, the delivery method for truth is important, and having fun in the office is a great way to boost morale. After high school, Tony headed to Harvard to earn a degree in computer science. For 3 years, he focused on school and stayed out of the business world. But during his senior year, he and his buddy Sanjay sold burgers and pizza in their college dorm. When they combined their sales with MTV videos playing in the background, the two of them found success. It was here they would meet future Zappos CFO/COO Alfred Lin, who was working a little side business of his own. Alfred bought one or two large pizzas from them every day and would take them to sell by the slice, earning him more per hour than Tony and Sanjay. Tony's desire to make money drove him to take a higher paying job with Oracle when he graduated. It became apparent shortly after starting that this was not the job for him. Thankfully, Sanjay had ideas of his own, introduced him to his World Wide Web idea, and the two of them borrowed $3 million from Sequoia Capital to start their own business. In 1996, Hsieh and Sanjay founded LinkExchange. 90 days after launch, LinkExchange had more than 20,000 web pages participating and had its banner ads advertised in excess of 10 million times. Their business continued to grow. 2 years later, Microsoft purchased LinkExchange for $265 million. His next business partner was Alfred Lin. The two Harvard grads co-founded an incubator and investment firm called Venture Frogs. Through their business, they invested in OpenTable, Ask Jeeves, and Zappos. Tony is an ideas man. He would never describe himself as a perfectionist. A procrastinator? Yes, but zero need to be a perfectionist. His mind was focused on how to make things work while having fun. Soon, he would be bringing that focus to a new set of people. Hsieh received a voicemail in 1999 that piqued his interest. Would Venture Frogs consider investing in an online shoe selling business? Nick Swinmurn told them that the shoe industry is a $40 billion market, and 5% of that was due to paper mail order catalogs. A few months later, Tony joined the Zappos team as their CEO. When he started with Zappos, they were doing $1.6 million. Rather than focusing on money, Hsieh focused on their company culture. This was not a typical move for a CEO, but there was nothing typical about the new Zappos CEO. Tony fully believed that if the culture was where it needed to be, everything else would align for the success of the business. With Tony's leadership, the company expanded from exclusively selling shoes to offering clothing, accessories, and electronics. At the same time, he made sure that customer service was a top priority. In 2008, the Harvard Business Review reported that Zappos published its 1-800 number on every single page of its website, and that its call center employees had free rein to do whatever it took to satisfy their customers' needs. Unlike many companies who make it nearly impossible to call directly and speak with a live person, Zappos put their number front and center, and they actually answered the phone. Real people, not machines, answered the phone. That lends itself to making true connections with customers. True connection, in turn, leads to loyal, repeat customers. Zappos' revenue hit $1 billion in 2009, and later that year, they were sold to Amazon for $1.2 billion. That sweet deal put a few million dollars in Hsieh's pockets while still allowing him to remain as CEO. At this point, his investment in Zappos was not only to keep his customers happy, but also to keep his employees happy. There was nothing traditional about their company culture. At Zappos, employees were encouraged to take total ownership of their work. They could dress to express their personalities, and tattoos were commonplace. Much like Tony's personality, the corporate culture at Zappos was unusual. Zappos soon became known as a fun place to work, decorated with giant stuffed animals, circled desks instead of cubicles, and sculptures that made noise. One conference room has a Star Wars theme with memorabilia and a mural of Darth Vader. Hsieh's goal was to create fun and a little weirdness. Tony poured his experience into the pages of a book in 2010. Delivering Happiness, A Path to Profits, Passion, and Purpose hit shelves and made the number one spot on the New York Times bestseller list. Hsieh would hold a place on the list every week for 6 months. The book was essentially an extension of the environment he created at Zappos. It discussed the importance of teamwork, a family atmosphere, an adventurous spirit, and open and honest relationships. For the next several years, Hsieh invested in a project to revamp the struggling portion of Las Vegas. In 2012, Tony invested $350 million into the downtown project. He wanted to bring a more tech-centered vibe to the area. The project consisted of a space to hang out, several restaurants, and a new bookstore. Tony was so committed to improving the area that he moved Zappos' headquarters there. After 20 years as CEO of Zappos, he decided to step down. At the ripe old age of 46, Tony retired in August of 2020. His only goal after retiring is to chase hard after his vision. Whatever he does, you can bet it will be fun. Tony Hsieh has always been an entrepreneurial visionary with a creative flair. His love for out-of-the-box living took him from worm farms in elementary school to Llamopolis, a trailer park filled with Airstream trailers, tiny houses, and you guessed it, llamas. Well, technically alpacas. He aptly named his little neighborhood Llamopolis. It is a place where people can stay in the other trailers, watch outdoor movies, and sit around nightly bonfires. Why does multimillionaire Tony Hsieh own two pet alpacas and live in a tiny Airstream trailer? He says, "I wanted to maximize serendipity and randomness in my life." For Tony, life is more about fun and functionality than money. He has always been about building a life that he loves. Trusting his vision and following his gut, Tony Hsieh now boasts a net worth of $840 million. On his journey to make people happy and improve his quality of life, he has embraced a very unconventional life, and he has become one of the richest men in America.
Hey, Dan Henry here, and I hope you enjoyed this episode of How They Got Rich. I created this channel because these men and women inspired me to quit my job years ago as a pizza boy and pursue entrepreneurship, which eventually led me to become a multi-millionaire. If you'd like to know more about that, you can follow me on my main YouTube channel, youtube.com/DanHenry. But before you go, I'd like to remind you why the people on this channel are successful, as well as myself. It's because they've mastered three main areas of their life: business, productivity, and mindset. And that's why I've made it my life's work to help others in those three key areas. So here are three ways I can help you right now. If you own a business and you're looking to grow it, you can head over to getclients.com and learn how we built a $20 million business, as well as learn how these strategies can apply to your business. You'll find a collection of free trainings, podcasts, and blog posts on that website to help you grow your business. As well, you can grab a free copy of my book, Digital Millionaire Secrets, which is a Wall Street Journal and USA Today bestseller. You can find that on getclients.com. Number two, you can head over to plantomorrow.com and check out the Plan Tomorrow Daily Planner. This is a planner I personally designed to make myself more productive and get things done. Because the truth is, if you want to do big things, you have to get things done. And I know this planner will help change your life like it's changed mine. For a limited time, it also comes with a free productivity class taught by me. So head over there right now and grab yourself a copy. And finally, number three, if you're struggling with mindset, confidence, motivation, imposter syndrome, or you're just looking to develop a rock solid mindset so you can achieve more in life, then I want you to head over to howtothink.com, where we have daily mindset mentoring on how to achieve anything in life by changing the way you think. So grab a copy of your Plan Tomorrow Daily Planner now. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next episode.